Fie, I'm right primed for another.
Ah, welcome to Tikawara. Happy day that the gods smile upon us. A favorable omen. I would shower you with the fruit of our harvest, but the season is unkind, I say. Kokokahara is restless. Even from afar, the storms tear our bounty up by the root and chase fish to calmer shores. An island not touched since the days of our ancestors. The Valians went to Pococahara for luminous Audra, but their expedition does not return. As the storms grow wild, Tikawara dies around us. No traveler will land here if they are forced to hit their belts, I say. You are new to the islands. I would not expect you to know of these things. Our ancestors told of luminous Audra, the bones of the dead fire, breaching through the sands of Kokokahara. Ngati raises her watery fist in defense of the Audra. Valian or Juana, it is nothing to her who suffers in the wake of such anger. Ikira, we paddle our canoes the long way around Kokokahara for a reason, I say. Another people lived among our ancestors and built a temple in the desert. Now there is only death.
Now that does tend to follow the Ngwithins.
But the Valians close their ears to my warning. Maybe that is for what the Valians find it so fascinating. Their captain brushed off my tails like the buzzing of gnats. Here, this was a token passed down from the Rankas, said to come from Pococahara in brighter days. If you need aid, Himurihi's warriors need only someone to bark commands and they will go. Wind and sorrow are all that emerge. Speak on, friend. What say? A village here is young still, but we will grow when the Valians come. That is for what we build many houses now, even a trading post. We make Tikawara pleasing to the Valians. Then when they come for Pococahara, they build their harbor here. Some tribes push foreigners away, but it is good to have powerful friends.
We got plenty of those. Ours are holding our lives ransom and playing us against their enemies.
If the Valians come, they will build an outpost here in Tikawara. Then we will have the trade, protection, and friendship of a mighty nation. A favorable arrangement for both sides, I say.
You sure you want to question that? We never get nice ones like this.
I say that in Tikawara, there is always a spot around the fire and... and a koiki in every hand. Speak on, friend.
Justice is most terrible when its blade falls on a friend, I say. Wrongy.
Indeed.
More outlanders. Are your masters so desperate that they send you to plunder a starving village? For what do you say this? To impress me? You are no different from the last ones who came through. Outlanders conquer us with ink and paper packs as well as blades. But they conquer us all the same. Akira. That is what the last bunch said. Ruanu. He collaborates with the bottom feeders who went to Pokukahara for Adra riches. I warned the Valians about Pokukahara, but why listen to the ignorant Huana girl? Now I remain. They are gone. Taken by the curse. Those who make for Pokukahara are devoured by Nagati, the trickster of the seas.
Forgive me for saying, but I ain't afraid of your goddess. I got a divine purpose, and so blessed protection from my god.
How comforted these outsiders must feel when they lie to themselves as well. Dark clouds surround Pokukahara, and in my dreams, they swallow us all. We tell these stories not because they happen just so. We tell them for what they mean. Our Rangosphere makes him too trusting. He believes the Valian traders will protect us if they settle here and mine Pokukahara. So the villagers pour their sweat into the sand, building a trading post on a barren island. If more Valians come? Akira, the same thing that has happened with every other foreigner. They will kill us, rob us, enslave us. And we will be too busy building their halls and sweeping their docks to fight.
Not sure if you and me be sharing the same definition of slavery, lass. But I don't think you'd be getting the particulars wrong.
The pirate knows nothing of this, I say. You are known as a friend to the Huana. If you did not win our favor to simply profit from us, then prove it now. If you go to Pokukahara, I say the best thing is to destroy it for the tribe.
It's always destroy. It's never renovate.
When the Adra is gone, the Valians will dig somewhere else, leaving us to point our canoes toward more welcoming shores. If I knew, then I would go myself. Anything that is built can surely be destroyed, Akira. And the storms are proof of powerful magic at work. Dispel this magic, banish it, whatever needs doing. I hope so. And we did not speak of this, Akira. Anaharu was a tribe's priest before me. And he was my father. Before he challenged Ruanu to a trial of waves. But he was cast off. We are forbidden to speak of him. When there is an argument between leaders that cannot be answered, we turn to Nagati. Two challengers risk violent currents, beasts from the deep, and waves that would dash them against the rocks. The winner, if there is one, has Nagati's favor. The loser, living or dead, is forgotten by Nagati and the tribe. My father knew the traders are as dangerous as pirates and slavers, perhaps more, because they grow strong in Neketaka. So, when the expedition came, he begged Ruanu to send them away and move the tribe to another island. Ruanu, he did not listen, and Anaharu was done talking. It means the tribe must forget him. The Ranga divided his possessions among the other Mataru, and now we do not speak of him. Anaharu goes to his next life, but forgotten, he goes to a different tribe. He is our Ranga. My own great aunt looked into his soul and declared him such. I must respect him, even as he builds a village for our enemies. Akira, I have, and so did Anaharu. Oh, I must learn to stop saying his name. We worship the same gods as the foreigners, but sometimes with different names. This is Nagati, the trickster of the seas.
You worship Gon same as I do, at least in Neketaka. But I'll admit I've never called Andra Nagati.
Foreigners know her as Andra. To us, there is no difference.
When I was little, me and my brothers used to spend hours chasing each other through the murkberry fields. Don't think a day went by I didn't have a skinned knee or a bleeding elbow.
Oh, we did that sometimes. Only my brother usually had a hand in the bleeding.
He older or younger than you? Either way, I bet he's just as strapping.
Older. Was. Was older. Then Rayed Sarah's invaded.
Oh, I didn't... I mean, I... Of course, it's... Gone, but I'm so sorry.
Thank you. Of course.
Of course.
Nice and quiet.
There is much to see.
Yeah.
Tell me, as you wish.
A Lloyd's foot and an heavy bullet, eh, Cap?
We're not alone.
Would you? Get there.
I see a soul in the darkness, one ready for reaping.
Gladly. I shall deal with this one. I'll see what I can find.
I'm here.
At once.
An invitation? Or a trap?
Oh, Anna. Oh, Anna. Oh, Anna.
I recall when you picked up ancient Ingwithin, but this?
Hatchling.
The scaly lass spied the Juana rounding up her pups. Marched them off towards the beach. Oh, condolences, ma'am.
Oh, Anna. Please, hatchlings.
Oh, we gotta do it.
As you wish. Stand together!
There's a wall up in!
Another attack, Captain.
Yeah.
For what do you linger here? The village is much too quiet.
But you do not laugh.
Then you do not joke. For what would I do this foolish thing? They are animals. They hunt where they smell food, and they smell food in our village. If I release the young ones, then they attack when they grow big.
Well, I hope they don't wait that long. I want to see them attack when they're little, with those tiny claws and fish teeth.
Then raise your hand to the little ones and see how they fight back. When they ran from me before, I thought it was only my weapon they feared. But suppose you are right. Then I do not have to suffer their stench. Take the key, then, and yell for help if anything goes wrong.
Look out! They escape!
I hope...
Thank you.